was done in Turkey in 2009. And the content of my presentation include introduction, methodology, results, conclusion, and the final part is my reflection. Introduction. In the story reading process, creating awareness on the schematic structure of the stories has positive effects on comprehending the text. So if we could have schematic structure in our minds while reading, we may comprehend the text more easily. And Linda and Plus proposed that using visual materials in comprehension process is important. Visual stimuli may facilitate comprehension, so the researcher wanted to explore the effects of visual stimuli in comprehension process. So the purpose of the study was to investigate the effects of the schematic structure of story text as a visual strategy on comprehension. As the schematic structure is formed with three components, the first one is linguistic schema. It involves vocabulary, grammar, and word phrase. And the second one is content schema. It involves the reader's background and world knowledge. Readers can use it to infer the context. The second one, the third one is formal schema. It involves structural characteristics of the text. Methodology. The participants were 99 sixth grade primary students, and the location is Turkey. Duration is 5-hour course, and method in this study is control group experimental design. The materials are two story texts. The participants were divided into three groups. First, 26 students in control group, and 38 students in experiment group 1. And 35 students in experiment group 2. Materials. For choosing the two stories, some criteria were taken into consideration. The first one is the number of the words. And the second one, the quality of the reading period. Third, being words of the same author. Fourth, the amount of unknown vocabulary. And fifth, the appropriateness of the theme to the background knowledge of the students. Procedure. In the beginning, the researcher did a pre-test. And then, traditional approach was applied for a control group. Here, the researcher didn't mention what is traditional approach. But I think many students just read the story from their textbook without any extra visual stimuli. And for experiment group 1 and 2, the researcher taught activities about schematic structure of the story. And post-test is the final step. In pre-test, the researcher read the stories for three groups, and then the students should answer interpretation questions and literal text questions. In post-test, the control group listened to the story, and then they should answer interpretation and literal text questions. And experiment group 1 read the story, but during this process, a slide showing schematic structure was projected to a curtain, and then the students answer questions. Experiment group 2 listened to the story, and during this process, handouts including schematic structure were distributed to the students. They could take notes on the handout while listening to the story, and then they answer interpretation and literal text questions. Instrument. In pre and post test, two types of questions were applied as instruments. So it shows that there is a significant difference in the achievement level of the students' listening comprehension between the control group and experiment group 1. Also, there is a significant difference in the achievement level of the students' listening comprehension between the control group and experiment group 2. However, there is no significant difference in the achievement level of the students' listening comprehension between the experiment group 1 and experiment group 2. Conclusion. From the results, we could tell that the use of story schematic structure as a visual strategy, as a listening activity, increased listening comprehension level of the students. And my reflection. First, although the researcher explained the schematic structure in literature review, but he didn't show his own example in the paper, so we could not tell what does the schematic structure look like. And second, since the researcher had experiment group 1 and 2, the treatment should be different, but why the researcher used the same treatment in experiment group 1 and 2?
Third,